Welcome to Occupy Van Halen, ladies and gentlemen. A rocket that comes from way, way back in our past all the way into what the future is going to look like according to. Welcome to Occupy Van Halen, ladies and gentlemen. Jockey shit. Here we go.
Oh, yeah, baby. Did it really got me, baby? Did it really got me, baby? bullets on silver. This is when I jumped out on that lonesome road.
Long time in coming out here. Turn me up out there, Frankie, so we can kind of talk in a little bit of a lower voice here, because we got a lot to talk about. I see a lot of familiar faces. I see a lot of folks who, a lot of writers, a lot of folks from the radio, a lot of folks coming from the internet, a lot of folks from the record company and everything. And man, oh man, it's a lot of folks that I kind of grew up with out here. Which one of you guys from the press knows Lady Gaga? I got to meet her. No, here's an interesting story, actually. I was watching, like, New Year's Eve, you know, and I saw the picture of Bloomberg with Gaga, and she had the mask and everything. Like, this perfect picture for New York City on New Year's Eve, man, New Year's Eve. And I started thinking about, you know, some of the New Year's Eves and stuff that I spent, you know, when Gaga was just starting to play. She played at a place called Pianos. You might know it down on Ludlow Boulevard. And it was before the spotlight found her. And this was just a handful of years ago. What she didn't know is that I lived about a half a block down the street on Ludlow and Rivington. I decided, I don't know, about 7 summers ago that I was going to go back to school and kind of have a little bit of the college shit that I never actually experienced before. And Ludlow and Rivington is inarguably the noisiest corner in all of the epicenter of the universe, much less New York City. And I became an EMT. I went into doing, put on the uniform. And we started to work on, I did my internship up at the 47th Precinct, which is the North Bronx. Is anybody from the Bronx up here? Okay. And I got to tell you, it was an eye into New York City that I don't think many people have, artist to artist, and there's a lot of you here who are artists. I want to speak to you artist to artist. Haven't you ever wondered about some of these buildings and some of these projects and some of these places we drive past every day, and you wonder, what's behind that door? Man, what's going on in there? What's up on the roof over there? Because, you know, as an artist, everything you see, everybody that you know, winds up in your voice. And I put on the uniform, and I got to tell you, I started seeing some amazing stuff, like North Bronx, Edenwald Projects, when it gets about as hot as it is in here, and it's August. First time I'd ever seen this. They take all of the extension cords, because folks don't have any cash. This is no news, yo. And they put all of the extension cords together. They're all different colors, and there'll be nine of them coming out of the sixth-floor windows. And they all join together at one beatbox. And somebody brought his radio down, six floors down, and they start to, and then they pick Grandma, who's usually in the wheelchair, and she sits and watches the beatbox, right? And then the little kids, you know, the peewees, they get her soda pops, you know, from the liquor store, and they get her a Starbucks sandwich or some shit. I guess I'd never seen anything like this before. Sometimes, though, they would forget Grandma. They would unplug the stereo, take it upstairs, and that's when they would 911 us. And things that you would never, ever imagine. Like, we would stand at the Dunkin' Donuts, and we would wait for the projects to fill up with water when it would rain, and we would know that the lights are going out, and pretty soon we got to go running up there. Hold on 1 second here, kiddo. Hold on 1 second here, fellas. They're giving me the key here. I want to tell you, though, we're close enough to the holidays here that you look in the rearview mirror, and I'll tell you about the best New Year's Eve ever. We're close enough to start to wish folks still close enough here, but the best New Year's Eve was when I worked the gig out at a hospital in Bed-Stuy, and it came, this wasn't just a few years ago, it was after the tour, and we got a cupcake. Fella came out at midnight and said, "Fellas, it's snowing. We ain't got much here." And he came out with there were three of us, came out with half a cupcake. And we stood in the snow in New York City, and we split a half a cupcake for New Year's Eve. So I want to wish you all a half a fucking cupcake for New Year's Eve. It's the very best that I could possibly share with you. Fellas, it's all apropos. Somebody get me a doctor! Turn the fog off.
Yeah.
the way the line goes up the back of those stockings.
Yeah.
seconds like this, vibration. And when you see you, when you see you, 45 minutes, cents a night of this. Look at this, I'm okay, I'm going to live out 5 years. And we used to play all the different neighborhoods around Southern California, because unlike on the East Coast, we're up here in the woods together. Lives next to Mr. Kassenberg, who lives next to Mr. Patel, and it's all in the same building. In California, Southern California at least, all the neighborhoods are a little bit different. The Venice Beach surf neighborhood is very different than the bikers in San Bernardino, and it's very different than the Spanish-speaking audience, which is in Pasadena, California, because below the Harbor Freeway towards Compton, that's where the lowriders live, and they speak Spanish, but it's a very different kind of local. Shit, you know, if you're gonna play for the lowriders, there's only gonna be some modern. And if you're gonna play for the bikers, then you're born to be wild at least five times a night. If you're gonna do Venice Beach, well, that was anything because they were all drunk anyway before you ever got here. Have you noticed that Van Halen fans have decided they've had a great time like 3 weeks in advance?
Woo! Yeah!
Van Halen fans are the ones who realize that the tailgate actually is the more important part of the
game. Yeah!
Dance, dance, dance the night away. Dance, dance, dance about the night stand. There is a road over here. Give me some delay out there, Frankie. Give me some echo on here. Make the shit sound a little bit. Really nice. I'm driving down the road. And the next thing I know. Yeah. All right, let's really go for a hybrid. We're at a club, and you can understand what I'm saying here a little better than you ever heard. We're going to go for Jim Morrison, does Stairway to Heaven. Is there a bustle in your head, drum? It's just a sprinkling for the made queen. I'm sorry, I began to riff. Who's got a drink? Somebody got a shot? Who's got a shot of something? Give me a sip of something over here. Order up a shot over there. Order up something. Waitress, get on over to the side here. Help me out with a shot here. I gotta have a double. I got a long drive home. Where's the waitress? Give me whatever's in your hand, Bersha. Give me that drink. Thank you. It's amazing what they can do in a cranberry these days, isn't it? Ooh, that shit is digital, too. They're pouring some serious drinks here. Let's hear it, baby. Everybody having a good time so far? We have a boulevard. It's Fountain Boulevard in Southern California. It's in Hollywood, actually. It's right below Sunset Boulevard. I got a lot of trouble for a public service announcement when I said, kids, don't drink and drive, but if you do, use Fountain. Okay. Let's get down to priorities here, because I'm going to reach down between them out. She's trying, I'm fine. Right behind her, I'll pull up your window. That's a feeling, power's here. There's another, I ain't lost, I'll be alive. Oh! in the movie Master and Commander, Far Side of the Earth, he sends a couple of the sailors up under the top of the crow's nest, and one of the guys says, you see that name carved into the banister? He says, the captain dug it in there when he was 12 years old, and he's been on this ship ever since. He learned every single job on the boat, and how many years later? Made the captain. That's what being the captain's all about. You know, every job on the boat by that time. I carved my name on one of the banisters down here in this basement when I was 7 years old. The first time I walked through that door was right after my 7th birthday. I was living on the East Coast, you know, family. And my pop was still in school, so we, you know, up until I was 13, something like that, we lived in little apartments. And summertime come around, the first time we drove into New York, I remember the lights. It was midnight, 1961. And I sat at the table right over there, and there was a Virgin Island steel drummer here. Fella singing in Calypso. My uncle Manny told me on the phone a couple nights ago that was Eddie Barkley. He's still with us. He lives out in Queens. But perhaps more importantly, that was the same year my uncle stood on this stage exactly as I stand in front of you and said, hey, we got a new poet, a new folk singer in town. His name's Bobby Zimmerman and he needs a place to shack up. True story. Well, it took us 50 years to get this gig. It was easier getting into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame than it was getting this gig. And now I want to get real, real serious. Because he's here tonight and he's 92 years old. Big hand for Uncle Manny off in the side of it. He says he's having the best time of his life. Anyways, it's full circle, yo. I remember Manny telling me about, most proudly, when I first time I walked in here, about the marble floor that you're standing on. He said it took him a year to lay that marble floor. On the last phone call, he's bragged about that marble floor again. This is a temple. This is a very special place. And I am more nervous about this gig than I would ever be at the Garden. There's no hiding up here. There's no hiding. There's no fake vocals. There's no fake any fucking thing. How are we doing? All right so far? Sometimes I'm babe and need something to keep you cool. Sometimes I'm babe and need something to keep you cool. You better look out now, I got something for you. I'd rush you, babe, you stop me when it passes by. I'd rush you, babe, you stop me when it passes by. Seen you on my way without a girl just to satisfy. Check me out. I got to put my body in the Dixie Cups. All the fills and push-ups do, I'm your eyes, man. Sound a little passing by. No, yes, sir. Yes, sir. And on my favorite, all the guarantee to satisfy. Wait a second. I'm your eyes, man. Stop me when I'm passing by. I'm your eyes, man. Stop me when I'm passing by. And on my favorite, all the guarantee to satisfy. Oh,
Thank you. Give me a pick, buddy. Give me a pick. Big Al! See you later, buddy!
Oh, my God.
Eddie, can you sign for your fans?
Eddie, can you sign okay? Eddie, sign real quick. Hey, Eddie.
Thank you, G.
Let's go, back up! Back up off the truck, move!